Thank you. Queen Marika is the...
Kree, you here for... I need to warn you about something. A little while ago, someone started lurking in the wing on the opposite side of the round table. And I can hear, from all the way over there, the howling and wailing of spirits in fear of a curse. I can even hear the repulsive twisted malice in itself. A plethora of spirits in an unceasing cacophony. I can't even imagine. How much suffering inflicted to who knows how many souls. Not even the grafting caused anything like this to happen. You should keep your distance. I know you're strong, but please. I feel like I'm really coming to grips with spirit tuning of late. I can see how and why immortal essence exists. A spirit under the Golden Order. I can understand their yearnings. What they become drawn to. Master Hugh said it himself, actually. That I'm no mere prentice any longer. Once again, I'm pleased to make your acquaintance. Roderica, the Certified Spirit Tuner.
Well, I took you no matter how you're up. The girl has come a long way. As ever, time and technique have made her stronger. 'Tis good to see. An imprisoned monster does not deserve an apprentice or a daughter. But at times, that's precisely what she feels like to me. I've gone soft. And it isn't easy.
Are you here for s-
Ah, I've decided to leave the round table hold after all. As I mentioned, I'm off in search of the noble gold mask. We may not meet again for some time. If there's any incantations you wish to learn, now's the moment. May the Golden Order shine through you.
Thank you. Have you ever felt the curse? With your whole being, the pox upon life itself, feared and despised by all. The reviled blessing. Apparently not. You are but a lamb, a stranger to defilement, ignorant of your own ignorance. You no longer interest me. I've been long without peace. Don't spoil my quietude. I asked you not to disturb. Be thankful of the whole serenity. It is all that keeps your death and defilement at bay.
No matter.